is the beginning.
Lesson one is...
give up. What happens now? You find yourself in what is perhaps a rather unfamiliar state of mind, just watching. Not trying to get anything, not expecting anything, not seeking. Just trying to relax, just watching without purpose. To be secure means to isolate and fortify the eye, but it is just the feeling of being an isolated eye which makes me feel lonely and afraid. In other words, the more security I can get, the more I shall want. To put it still more plainly, the desire for security and the feeling of insecurity are the same thing. To hold your breath is to lose your breath. No man ever steps in the same river twice, for it's not the same river and he's not the same man. If even a single night has passed, the more things tend to be permanent, the more it tends to be lifeless. Religions are divisive and quarrelsome. They are a form of one-upmanship because they depend upon separating the saved from the damned, the true believers from the heretics, the in-group from the out-group. All belief is fervent hope, and thus a cover-up for doubt and uncertainty. The experience of pain is universal, and all religion starts from pessimism, for without the experience of pain in one form or another, there will be no reflection on life. And without reflection, no religion. How does one bring oneself into accord with it? If you try to accord with it, you will get away from it. For to imagine there is a you separate from life, which somehow has to accord with life, is to fall straight into the trap. If you try to find the truth, you are at once presupposing a difference between yourself and the truth. But I have realized that the past and the present are real illusions, that they exist only in the present, which is what there is and all that there is. From one point of view, the present is shorter than a microsecond. From another, it embraces all eternity. But there isn't anywhere, or anywhen, else to be, other than right here, right now, in this reality, to be. Other than this, right here in this reality, right here in this reality, right here. Few of us have ever met an angel and probably would not recognize it if we saw one, and our images of an impersonal or suprapersonal god are hopelessly subhuman. Jello. Featureless light. Homogenized space, or a whopping jolt of electricity. It's an overwhelming light. The meaning of life is just to be alive. It is so plain and so obvious and so simple, and yet everybody rushes around in a great panic as if it were necessary to achieve something beyond themselves. Realize that the past and future are real illusions, that they exist in the present, which is what there is and all there is. There is no formula for generating the authentic warmth of love. It cannot be copied. You cannot talk yourself into it, or rouse it by straining at the emotions, or by dedicating yourself solemnly to the service of mankind. No work or love will flourish out of guilt or fear or hollowness of heart. Just as no valid plans for the future can be made by those who have no capacity for living now. We seldom realize. For example, that our most private thoughts and emotions are not actually our own. For we think in terms of languages and images which we did not invent, but which we were given to us by our society. We cannot be more sensitive to pleasure without being more sensitive to pain. And that's the curse of life, as blessed as it is, seeming utterly lame. Fall back on life to remain sane.
To remain sane, even though I'm insane.
No one is more dangerously insane than one who is sane all the time. This is the real secret of life, to be completely engaged in what you are doing in the here and now.